Good day from ChemHelp ASAP. Determining the concentration of a molecule in a living organism is very difficult. One issue is that a drug is not uniformly distributed in a patient. The amount of drug in a patient's bones is likely different from the amount in one's muscles. Unfortunately, there is no good way to sample all parts of the body. The best solution to this problem is to measure drug concentrations by drawing a patient's blood. Blood is sampled for two reasons. First reason, it's convenient. For a drug that treats headache pain, you certainly wouldn't want to drill into a person's head. Instead, you sample the drug from a more convenient tissue and location, like blood from one's arm veins. Second reason for sampling blood, it is informative. The concentration of drug in blood is related to the concentration of the drug in other parts of the body. If the blood concentration doubles, then the concentration in other places, like the brain, also doubles. By monitoring drug concentration in the blood, you know how concentrations are trending in other parts of the body. When blood is sampled from the body, drug concentrations are normally not determined in blood. Whole blood is hard to analyze because it's a complex mixture of fluid and cells. Therefore, the cells are removed from whole blood to give just the liquid portion called plasma. Plasma is then analyzed for the drug to give a plasma concentration, or CP. So how does CP vary with time in the body? Let's look at a typical CP time curve for an oral drug. So we'll draw axes. There's our y-axis, followed by our x-axis. Our y-axis is plasma concentration. This is typically mass over volume, micrograms per liter, something like that. And then the x-axis is time. When a patient takes a drug in pill form, the plasma concentration, the y-axis, starts at zero. The drug enters the stomach and perhaps later the small intestine. In a short amount of time, the time being the x-axis, the drug will begin to be taken up from the digestive system and enter the bloodstream of the patient. At this point, the CP will rise rather rapidly and continue to rise until the drug has been completely absorbed. At this stage, the observed CP will begin to drop as the body either breaks down or excretes the drug. The concentration will slowly tail off. While monitoring plasma concentration of a drug is not the same as knowing the concentration of a drug at its site of action, CP values are regardless both very convenient to determine and informative for following the drug in a living organism.